Livestock production in Spain has grown steadily since the 1960s and currently represents 40% of the gross agricultural product. Due to its diverse geography, Spain has a wide variety of climates, agricultural traditions, and livestock breeds. Cattle production in Spain is clearly separated into breeding farms and feedlots. Feeder beef cattle are either imported or come from national breeding or dairy farms. Feeder calves are bought at two stages of growth, called mamones, about 2 months old, and pasteros, about 5 months old. The main type of cattle bred for meat in Spain is the añojo, an entire male yearling with a live weight of around 500 kilos. Beef cattle are normally fed ad libitum, and fresh water is supplied automatically in cups or bowls. The pens are open and get plenty of natural light and fresh air. Normally, there is very little noise, and animals are frequently in contact with humans. The animals are housed in pens, untied, with about 20 to 45 animals. In high-level fattening systems, two cycles are performed for a total of about 90 animals per year. There is a high level of standardization in the production, partly in order to obtain European subsidies. More than 75% of the feedlots have a loading race and 65% a loading ramp, but they are not normally covered by a roof. The ramp is angled at around 20 degrees and made of cement with anti-slip grooves. Ramps have a side railing more than 1 meter high and are made of brick or hollow metal bars. The most frequently used vehicle is an unarticulated truck with two axles and capacity for two groups of 4 to 5 animals. There is natural ventilation and the trips are relatively short, averaging 3 hours on a national level. Most of the trucks used to transport cattle are owned by the driver. Special courses for drivers are now being developed by the Spanish Ministry of Agriculture. Short trips, less than 2 hours, are usually made in two-axle lorries with an average floor surface area of 12 meters squared, which can be divided into two compartments by a mobile gate. During the course of the project, we contacted and interviewed cattle breeders and obtained the full collaboration of ASOVAC, the Spanish Cattle Breeder Association. In general, farmers, hauliers, and abattoir personnel were very cooperative. During loading, there is normally no regrouping. Animals are loaded in groups and not tied. They are coaxed with a solid stick, but many farmers only use voices and hand clapping. Loading can occur at very different times of the day or even night, but about half the farms load in the morning. The average reported loading time is very short, less than 15 minutes. The farmer participates in the loading with the driver. The most common problems in loading involve certain breeds of cattle that appear to be more nervous and difficult to handle. No important animal welfare problems were mentioned by the farmers. Most farmers are aware of the risk involved in a bad loading and high animal density on the truck. Here we see one of our experimental animals equipped with a polar heart rate sensor. Loading is an important stress and may be more stressful than transport itself. It should proceed quickly and with few negative behavioral events, such as falls or slips. After the paperwork is finished at the farm, animals are on their way to the abattoir. Most journeys are short on highways and asphalted roads. The abattoirs are outside of the large cities, so it is not necessary to go through the cities to reach them. Environmental conditions on the truck are not well inspected, and ventilation is normally passive. The most problematic trips occur in summer at very high temperatures. Nonetheless, our studies have shown that season or transport time have little effect on meat quality and only a slight negative effect on animal welfare when performed correctly. Average road speed is 70 kilometers per hour. In general, most trucks only made one stop to load. Hauliers are normally well experienced and have been quite keen to participate in our project. Many have assisted to our meetings we organized in Catra. Most abattoirs in Spain are private and about 25% are public. Here we see a lorry with 8 animals arriving to unload at a public abattoir. animals are not regrouped during unloading. Normally, the driver unloads the truck, sometimes with the help from abattoir employees. Unloading races are common but rarely weather tight. All abattoirs have unloading facilities. The ramp is normally at the height of the truck with a smooth downward slope and surrounded by side blocks. Most unloading points have natural and artificial light available. Waiting time on the truck before unloading is normally short, as well as the unloading time. Normally, layerage is overnight, with ad libitum water and no food. Are led to be stunned in the morning. The stunning boxes do not have restraining devices. All abattoirs use captive gun stunning. Few abattoirs verify pH or carcass temperature, but DFD meat is rare in Spain, officially under 8%. In the conditions of our study, transport times of up to 6 hours had little effect on instrumental or sensorial meat quality.